Hi and welcome to today's guitar lesson on how to play the acoustic guitar part of Impossible by Nothing But Thieves, one of my favorite songs at the moment. The notes the singer hits, it's just unbelievable, and I love the way they work with dissonance in the song. Like, we've got all these pretty cool chord shapes. It's not your everyday four chord pop song, and it also has this nice James Bond vibe to it with this chromatical falling, rising and falling, which I really like. Anyway, let's get to it and jump right in with the intro. So I've seen him play it on his acoustic guitar with a capo on the first fret in the live orchestra version on Abbey Road, and I'll just call the notes and chord shapes related to the capo. So for the intro and verse, we have the same as the original riff. So we play E major, but we don't play it in the way that you probably know it. We're just going to switch our middle and ring finger around. So we have the ring finger on the second fret of the A string and the middle finger on the second fret of the D string. And we play A, D, G, D. And now we can use this finger position to slide our ring and index finger up one fret, but keep our middle finger on the second fret of the D string. Okay, this is a really easy transition, which is why we used this chord shape of an E in the first place. So we've got it. Picking is just gonna stay the same. So A, D, G, D. And from here, we just put our pinky in front of our ring finger and then stretch out our index finger into the first fret of the G string. So we have 4, 2, 1. And we're just going to play the same thing again. So A, D, G, D. And then back to our chord shape from before. So just lift up the pinky again and slide the index finger back into the second fret of the G string and play the same thing again. So all together, really slowly, we have this. And we're just going to repeat this over and over again. What you can also do as an alternative is to slide into the second chord shape. Okay, so this, which is what the electric guitar sometimes does. Just keep on repeating this over and over, as I already said, and then at one point before going into the chorus, we go up to this C major 13, and after that we just pluck the open A string. Oh, by the way, the chord shapes, the chord names are E major, C major 13, and then kind of like a C sharp minor over E. Okay, and then open A string to move into the chorus. Now for the chorus, we have three different options that we can choose from. First option is going to be the electric guitar part, which is this E major. From here we go to an E6, which is just the exact same way as the E major, but with our pinky on the third fret of the A string. Okay, nice dissonant chord. And then we just play a C5 power chord, which is, oh sorry, C sharp 5 power chord, which is 4, 6, 6, and then down this power chord shape to the third fret, which is a C5 power chord. Okay, so the electric guitar part sounds like this, using the strumming pattern, down, 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 up. We've got down, 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 up. Second time around, we go to a B chord to go into the second part of the chorus. This is exactly the same for all of the three options. Second option is going to be simple chords. We go E major to a open C chord to a C sharp minor bar chord, or if you don't want to play a bar chord, you can also play it with an open high E string, okay? No matter which way you play it. And then from here, we go to an open C again. So we have, sorry, and then second time around, same thing as with the other option before. We finish on this B for the second part. And the third option that we have, which is the actual acoustic part that he plays, is going to be an E major again, but this time I play it kind of like a bar chord without the bar, so with my middle finger on the first fret of the G string. and pinky and ring finger on the second fret of the A and D string. And then from here, we just switch our ring and middle finger up one fret and put our index finger onto the second fret of the D string, which is the C major 13 again, just with a different finger shape than before. Okay, and then from here we go to a C sharp minor 7 in an open position, I would say. So we have ring finger on the fourth fret on the A string, index finger second fret on the D string, and then pinky on the fourth fret of the G string, and then open B and E string. Okay, back to our C major 13. So for the acoustic guitar part, we have same thing as before, up to the C sharp minor and then B. Whichever alternative you choose is really up to you. It all works perfectly fine, but I'm going to stick with the acoustic guitar part because I think that the chords here sound the fullest. So from here we go from our B, which is the same for all of the three options, to an A major bar chord, to a G sharp minor, to an F sharp minor 7, G sharp minor again, A, G sharp minor, and then F minor. Okay, and we've got this down, 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 and you can also abruptly stop it to play staccato, like, and you just do that by releasing the pressure of your fingers after strumming it. Okay, so again, A bar chord to G sharp minor bar chord to F sharp minor 7. The interlude that we have in between then is going to be the same as the intro. So just this picked, sorry. And then when we go into the second verse, we use exactly the same chord shapes, but this time we're going to strum it, and we're going to focus mostly on these three strings that we have been playing the whole time before. Okay, so we've got this. You can also put like a slight palm mute on it if you want. But yeah, that's completely up to you, as I already said. And then from here, we go into the second chorus, which is just exactly the same as before, no differences here. And then for the bridge, we're going to play almost two bars of this B bar chord. So we have one and two and three and four and one and two and three. We go to the C sharp minor, strum this three times, and then go down to an A chord on the one end, so kind of like on the offbeat. And then we do the same thing with A minor and F sharp minor as we did with a B and C sharp minor. So we play A for almost two bars, and then on the three end we move to this F sharp minor. So the bridge should sound like this. We do this two times, and the second time around, after having played the F sharp minor, we just go and end the bridge on this E major chord and let that ring out. Then for the next chorus, we just do the same thing as before, then the chord progression played twice as an instrumental. So the chorus chord progression played twice as an instrumental. And then we play a little outro, which is going to be exactly the same as the intro and verse. And that's already the whole song, the whole acoustic guitar part. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial and that you can now play this song. In case you did enjoy it, remember to leave a like and check out my channel for more guitar lessons. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you there again soon. Goodbye.